What is going on, guys and girls? My name is James, or ThnxCya, and welcome back today to Crazycraft. How are you doing, everyone? Welcome back. So today, as always, guys, we've got some plans, and oh, wow, look at that. That'd be such a cool screenshot. I'm going to take a screenshot. Boop, there we go. Happy days. So yeah, today we have some plans and some cool bits and pieces that I would like to do. And yeah, I'm sure if you guys have been watching this series so far, you will have known the last few episodes, we've kind of been pretty much looking into the Witchery mod, getting the very, very basics done. But yeah, as we kind of established last episode, we are going to have to move kind of our Witchery area into another large area. DanTDM has joined the game. Oh my god, look at this. Hello. Oh god, hang on. Hello. There we go. Okay, awesome. So he's actually just been on like 5 minutes ago. That's probably going to be quite confusing. But anyway, so yeah, we're going to take a little break from Witchery, and we are probably going to be doing a little bit of exploring today, actually. I want to go and try and find some dungeons and try and kind of do something a little bit different. But the one thing that I do want to do beforehand, which we were prepping, is finally go and make ourselves the leech chest. So last episode, we finally managed to actually make ourselves the mutating sprig, which we do need to use in order to kind of like grow this weird leech chest. So the things that we're going to need to do are, we're going to have to get ourselves some vines, we're going to have to get ourselves like a weird sort of diggy structure, we're going to have to get ourselves a trap chest, and we're going to have to use the mutating sprig on the chest, which will give us the leech chest. So I've been doing a few things around here. I've basically just been making the essentials. So we have a kettle here, which is very, very snazzy. I like it very much, but this is used for the witchery brews. Now, I did want to make the, what's it called? Redstone something. Bear with redstone. The redstone soup. Yeah, the redstone soup goes inside of the chalice, and then that will actually boost like the power and the effectiveness of the altar and stuff. But we do need a few other items. We need tongue of dog, which you can only get from actually killing wolves, which is a little bit grim, but we're gonna have to do it. And we actually do have something from bats as well, like wool of bat. Kind of cool. So I've made myself a second Arthana here. So if you actually kill the wolves and the, I think it's bats, I could be wrong, but if you kill them with the Arthana, then you have a higher percentage drop rate for those items. So there's loads and loads of brews. We'll get into that at some point, but I thought we'd just make the kettle. And as well as that, we have also made this bad boy here, which is the distillery. So I've just tried it here. I've made myself some gypsum using quicklime. And quicklime is cool because you just like literally put one piece of ash in the crafting table and you get one piece of quicklime. So that's all used for the other things. So I'm looking into circle magic now, and I want to start making the chalks. And then you need, like, this sort of stuff for the chalks. But we'll come back to that, lads. Don't worry, we've got plenty of time. Plenty of time. So, ooh, another thing. So you may have seen this at the end of Justin's last Crazycraft episode. I wasn't recording at the time. I just came on to basically... I come on here like, oh, I've missed a block. No, it should be black. Oh, the whole base is ruined. That's going to really annoy me. I'll fix it, don't worry. But yeah, I come on like every day just to make sure that Pac-Man hasn't destroyed my home. I've got a little bit of Pac-Man paranoia going, to be honest with you, because they do really suck, and they just have a tendency to pop up and destroy everything. But yeah, I bumped into Justin, and he showed me this awesome, awesome recipe here for some of this stuff. So check this out. This is duct tape, and this is an amazing alternative to our anvil pet, and it's actually much, much cheaper. So basically, for example, here you can see the ultimate bow is nearly broken, but if we right-click, look at that. It repairs the bow up. So, oh god, no, fire in the house. I think we're safe. So, it does repair the items up. So, undoes? What button did I just click? I have no idea. Oh, no more undoes. Okay, so yeah, it's completely repaired the bow, and it is super, super cheap in order to do. Look at that. So, we're probably going to be using a lot of this duct tape, especially for our ultimate gear. Although, having said that, the anvil pet is really useful when you're out and about, and it's kind of just slowly repairing your gears. But yeah, thanks, Justin. Really cool tip. So, apart from duct tape, what are we going to do? What are we going to do? Oh, yeah, leech chest. Okay, we're going to need to get some stuff. I'm going to need my shears. So, we go iron, we go stick, and we go wood, tripwire, and then we go... Oh, what's a chest? That's a chest. Yeah, boom, chest. Stick the chest in, stick the trap wire, hooky thingamajig in, boom, trap chest. Pretty good. Now what we have to do is this. So we need to go like that, I think. And then we need to go one more down on each of these sides. We need to put a Trap chest in the middle. We need to go vine here, vine here, vine here, vine here. And now we need some water. Boop. 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 And boop. Haha, there we go. So, fingers crossed, is this going to work? Ah, yes, it did. Boom. Wow, okay, so I thought this mutating sprig would be a one-use item, but it's not. It's got a durability. That's pretty cool. But yeah, check this out. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is our leech chest. So, pretty nifty, I've got to say. We can break it, I believe, and we can carry it around. So let's give it like that. But yeah, so I'm going to show you this in case you've never seen it before. Check this thing out. Really, really cool. Now, it's a bit difficult to show you because I'm going to have to open it. But when we open it, can you see the top of it? Oh, it's so cool. And this little pocket here, this is a sample of our own blood, like our DNA. So, yeah, really, really cool. We can use a tag. I don't know. Can we use a tag log kit on our own? I'm not sure. But we can move this and the DNA thing will stay in there. So that's pretty cool. That was a lot of work for one leech chest, but I'm glad that we've got it. So let's, let's put it somewhere secret for now. Let's just stick it in here. That'll do. Perfect. And what I want to do is, let's go exploring. Yeah. Let's go maybe this direction and see what we can find. I spy a wild DanTDM. Hello. So there appears to be something that he's built here. Let's not ruin it. Oh, Pac-Man. Pac-Man. Close. Okay, so I didn't want to, I'm not going to spoil what he's built here. If you guys want to see what he's built and see it all inside and stuff, then you're going to have to go check out his video. We'll check it out in a later video. But I have actually spotted Pac-Man outside his house. So, is there a message from Dan in capital letters? He's so close. Yep. Yes, he is. Okay, let's, does he eat every block? Hang on, wait. Usually, like, I think Pac-Man usually eats woods and stuff. I think. Let's go and help Dan here. Hopefully, he will come and help me with this because, well, we'll see. We'll see. Okay, so let's, Dan, come on, help. Where are you? All right, here we go, lads. Here we go. So, Pac-Man is going down. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Here we go. So, we've got a bit of damage on him, which is good. Oh, God, move him away from the base. Oh, I'm in a hole. I'm being useless. Come on. Quick. DanTDM was slain by Pac-Man. No. I want him to stay away from the base. Hang on. I'll steer him away. We need to get him away from Dan's base. I don't want to try and spoil it too much because I want you guys to watch it. Oh, Justin's arrived. Oh, God. Okay, now we got the full team. Pac-Man, go away. Go away, dude. Here, use this. There you go. There we go. Okay, Dan, you can do it, buddy. I believe in you. Go. Let's go. Let's roll deep. Okay, there we go. He's got the ultimate bow. All right, we should be able to do this now, guys. Here he goes. Yeah. Woo. Nice. There we go, dude. He's on his side. Yeah. Nice. Okay, here we go. Is Dan going to finish him off? I think he is. Go. I believe in you. And yay. Yay. Nice. Well, we had to start somewhere, and yes, it is a lucky block. So I'm kind of just walking around trying to find some cool new stuff. I just came across a coven witch, which was pretty cool, but I couldn't find the area that I think they live in. So that's something that we really want to look into for witchery. But, all right, okay, ready? 3, 2, 1, go! Oh, what is it? It is a dun-dun-dun lucky fishing rod. Yay! Could have been better. It could have been worse. Oh, perfect. Okay. So this is... Whoa, easy now. What the heck was... Is that you? Dude, zero chill here. Oh, no, there's criminals. There's criminals, lads. Okay, and there's a massive wasp as well. All right, so this is something that I want to do. So we've actually found a few wolves. Now, unfortunately, we will actually have to kill these guys, which I know is kind of cruel, but we do need the tongue in order to continue with the witchery. So this is something that I hope we bump into. The Arthana is going to be useless, so we've got to try and do a little bit of damage first. Oh, God, criminals everywhere. Where are these guys coming from? Are you serious? Okay, they're not too bad. Ooh. Right, now if everything could just leave me alone for 2 seconds here, we should be able to do what we want to do. So let's give this a go. I'm kind of worried I'm going to anger quite a few of them in doing this, because they're kind of like, you know, all together. But if we try and weaken a few of them, so is that going to kill them? No, that should be fine. And then if we try and use this sword to take them down, we should be able to get what we need. Oh, they've not got too much health, which is good. Come on, give me the drop. Give me the drop. Give me your tongue. Yes, there's one. Okay, we need one. Are we going to get two? Yes, and three. Perfect. Hey, so this is what we were looking for. Let's get rid of the dandelions. These guys, which we can now use for some witchery recipes. So this is Tongle's dog. Let's put it in our backpack for safekeeping. Oh my goodness, I've just seen the best hat in the world. Oh my goodness. No, don't you dare get away. Look, it's the mighty Derpichu. Oh my goodness, all hail the mighty Derpichu. Yes. Oh, we've had not enough Derpichu in this Let's Play. Yes. Oh my goodness. Lads. Oh, there's a mantis over there. Ladies and lads, we have been reunited with the mighty Derpichu. Where is it? Please be here somewhere. Where are you? What were you called again? Oh, this one. Oh, God. All hail the mighty Derpichu. Oh, I missed you, buddy. Ooh, okay. I see a little mini spawny thing. So let's go and check this out. So, ooh, there's lots of stuff around here. There's, like, loads and loads of mobs and stuff. There's loads of marble. This is what I've built most of my base out of. As you can see, it's, like, all over the shop. But it's a really nice colour. Okay, this is not the right way to go. Let's go and check out this. Oh, come on. Fingers. Yes, there we go. Let's go and check this bad boy out. So I did see a mantis around here. We could do with killing some mantis, to be honest. We do have a load of mantis spawn eggs that we got from a dungeon, but I do plan to use those at some point as a little thingamajig. We'll go more into that later on. But yeah, ooh! Rubber duckies. Hello! Oh, you're so sweet. Let me kill you. I want to warp into one of you. What do they do? Do they just... They're not very... I don't really fear these ducks, to be honest with you. Do they just... Are they literally just ducks? Okay, fair enough. So... Huh. What do they drop? They drop spawn rubber ducky. Okay, so we can actually... If we kill them, we get an egg, which we can drop. They're spawning loads of them, so these aren't pretty good. But okay, let's see if we can get into here. So let's break open that. Let's climb. Where's our ultimate pickaxe? There she is. Okay, let's go and see what's in this chest. Hopefully it's pretty good. Urgh, come on. How do I? Yes, there we go. What do I gotta do to make you open? Yes, there's one. And there's two. And who? Ooh. Loads of fish. What the heck is this stuff? Okay, so I've not seen these before. I'm going to take it because it's new. What a weird thing. Oop, lucky block number two. So, yes, we don't really find, like, that many of these lucky blocks, to be honest, which is probably a good thing. Oh, I love this tree. We're going to steal that in a minute. Okay. Oop. Ooh. What's this? We got a lucky sword. Yeah. So, it's not that powerful, to be honest, but it is going to be perfect because we are looking for items which we can display in our base. We've got a peacock spawn egg. Interesting. But yeah, that's really good. So that's a cool item that we can get. Let's steal this tree and all of its beautiful saplings. I think this is a cherry tree, right? Yeah, it is. There's something up ahead. I don't know what it is, though. Is that sponge? Ooh, that could be useful, actually. Hey, okay, so let's go and check this out. I have no idea what this is. It looks like... I actually have no idea. It's super, super ugly. But let's see if we can get inside. It doesn't really say what it is. Let's go underneath and maybe... Have we got any blocks? No, we've got some wool, which our sheep pet keeps giving us. Let's actually dig ourselves up. A little bit of dirt here. Oh, yes, the speed! So good. Okay, we got ourselves some dirt. Pretty awesome. Let's get rid of this walnut because we have no time for you, walnut. Okay, and let's go and check this out. There's troll pole. Ooh, there's a chest inside. Hey. Okay, so nothing appears to be spawning. Yes, there is. Yes, there is. Destroy it. Kill it with fire. James. No. Oh, it's a hive. Oh, okay. Oh, these horrible bees. No, I've angered the bee lords. No. We good? I think we're good. Matt, we got to that quick. Those things, like, they're not that strong, but if there's enough of them, they do a decent amount of damage. So what have we got? Wow! Look at this stuff. This is cool. So we've got... Let's get rid of some of this rubbish. We've got some pink leggings, a pink hat, a more experienced orb catchers. We've got this cool fairy sword. Yes, this is exactly what I want. I want, like, weird things to put in my base. And I think we're doing pretty good. Nice. Ooh, I think I spy the caterpillar doing it. Oh, look, this is one of these things again. Ah, so remember, this is the last time when we got ourselves a ton of mantis spawn eggs and just all this cool stuff. We actually got it from one of these mantis traps. Now, okay. Wasn't quite expecting that. Oh my goodness. Okay, there's a lot of mantis. Okay, we should actually try and farm these guys, because if we farm them, we can get all of the uranium and titanium ingots, and then we can use them to make ourselves the ultimate armor, and we can get the ultimate, all that good stuff. So let's do some business here on these guys. Oh, as if you're attacking me, dude, you're so small. Okay, things are going pretty well. Things are going pretty well here. We've got ourselves... not that much, actually, to be honest with you. We've not got that much of what I'm looking for here. But I thought it would be a good idea to kind of just hang around for a bit and see if we can actually get some more. Because, yeah, the ultimate armor would be amazing. I really like the armor that we've got, but something like a bit more powerful would be pretty sweet. So let's see if we can... This thing is... Go away, you little... That lance is so annoying. All right, okay, let's see if we can trigger this off again. Go! Oh, that's not going to do it. Okay. Okay. This is going to be another load of just insane stuff. Oh, okay. Now it's spawned, lads. Run. Okay, that was a serious climb. Oh, my goodness. We are so high up here. I bet there's nothing up here. I bet this entire journey was pointless, but I kind of wanted to take a look anyway. Whoa, okay. Man, I don't think there's anything here, though. No, it's literally just a massive, massive mountain. Well, that's annoying. All right, fine. Come on, sheep pet, save me. Yes, easy. Oh, okay. Oh, it's these things. Okay, so I believe we can actually tame these guys with beef. Is that true? How? Is this supposed to be raw beef? Let me put it in your face. I don't want to get too close. I don't. Oh, you know what? I need to Google it. I don't trust myself. Ooh, lucky block number 3. Okay, pretty cool. So let's pop this bad boy. Oh, whoa. Okay. No. What was that? A Leona Flerix, big dragon. There it is. So it's attacking loads of stuff. Whoa, it's so cool. Oh, and it's dead. Oh, I wanted to kill that, dude. Well, that's an... Oh, what's it dropped? Ooh, cool stuff. What are these? These are Kraken repellents. I feel like these are quite useful. GG, buddy. I like you. Whoa. Oh, my goodness. Look at this. So this is an NPC village, but because it's in the snow biome... Oh my goodness, we found Elsa's village. This is totally where Elsa lives. Let it snow, let it go. I am one with the villagers. Oh, look, this is so cool, man. Look, wow. This is awesome. I love this village. This is totally where Elsa would live. I'm just saying, this is exactly it. This is awesome. Hey, so I think this is just like a standard village, but the way it's made is so, so cool. I don't think there's any loot chests in here, which is kind of annoying, but I love this. What are you doing to these poor goblins? Oh, dude. That is so cruel. Ow, they're now shooting me. Why are they so... Stop. I'm gonna avenge this goblin. God damn you guys. Oh, God, they're really strong. Okay, never mind. Run away. Oh, Elsa's village sucks. Let's go. All right, well, seeing as we're cracking, like, so many of these, we're finding loads. Let's do one more lucky block. So I think this is going to be the final thing for today's episode. Oh! Ah! It's all sweet! It's Mr. Rainbow and all his sheeps. I like this. Okay, so there we go, ladies and gentlemen. I think that's going to be about it for today's Crazycraft episode. I just wanted to do something a little bit different. We've been spending a few episodes in and around the base, so every now and again, I just want to sort of branch out and, you know, go and do some exploring and go and find some new stuff. We've got a backpack full of awesome gear and, yeah, pretty awesome. So thank you so, so much for watching this episode, and also just once again, thank you so much for the incredible support for the Crazycraft series so far. It really means the absolute world to me, and I'm really, really happy that you guys are enjoying it. So yeah, thank you so, so much. As always, guys, before you go, please remember to poke me in that like button. If you get over 2,000 likes, that would be awesome. And yeah, also, if you're not yet subscribed, go for it, because we do Minecraft on fun. But until next time, thank you once again for watching. It's been such a pleasure. As always, thanks. Hang on. Bear with. Run to you.